All right, so right now there is an incredibly expensive and delicate object that's actually heading out into space, bringing decades worth of hopes and dreams of people around the world with it. In fact, the James Webb Space Telescope launched into space on Christmas Day, tucked inside the nose cone of a European Space Agency rocket. Within minutes of the launch, all the rocket's parts fell away, and now the telescope itself is on its own, heading for its ultimate home nearly a million miles away. But it will take the telescope about a month to get there. Look at this timeline. The little yellow triangle way off there on the left side of your screen is the current position of the telescope. And the farthest right object on that timeline, that is where it is going. And while it's trying to get there, the telescope will also go from looking like this to looking like this. It will take hundreds of maneuvers over the next 4 weeks for the telescope to fully unfold all of its unnecessary parts. And if anything goes wrong at any point, there's basically nothing humankind can actually do about it. We can't send somebody out there to fix it. The James Webb Space Telescope is years behind schedule. It's billions of dollars over budget, but it has finally left Earth. And should everything continue to go well, it is going to be amazing. Joining us now is someone who has been watching and waiting for this mission for years. He is Matt Kaplan, host of Planetary Radio, which is the Planetary Society's weekly podcast devoted to space exploration. I encourage everyone to give it a listen. Thank you so much, Matt, for being with us. So first off, I mean, does it feel real yet that this thing has actually gotten off the ground? It's gone from being just a, you know, conceptual to now being a reality. This telescope is, as I mentioned, billions of dollars over budget, years behind schedule. But alas, it is in space.
Thank goodness. So many of us have been waiting so many years. Many people from the beginning of the planning of this kind of telescope for nearly 30 years for what is happening in space right now. And you're right, we got a long ways to go before it is completely deployed. So far, so good, but there are a lot more steps ahead of us. But man, if it all comes together the way it's supposed to, it is going to knock our socks off.
So tell me a little bit about the steps that you're looking forward to right now. I mean, what's the latest on the telescope's progress? Have there been any hiccups? I mean, what's the scariest part of this telescope's journey in the weeks ahead?
Scary is the right word. I mean, I can tell you, knowing some of the scientists and engineers behind it, they are thrilled, but it is an anxious time because they know how much is left to be done. What we've seen so far is the deployment of the solar panel and the antenna that is capable of sending lots and lots of data, because these pictures take up a lot of room, back to Earth. That happened automatically. But what is about to start as soon as tomorrow is the deployment of this gigantic tennis court-sized five-layer solar shield, which you can actually see in the animation right now, beginning to unfold. That by itself is so complex, it's going to take almost a week for that to happen. And there are a lot of essential steps after that.
And I know that we can talk about this for hours, but now just tell me briefly, what is this telescope going to tell us about where we come from and whether or not we are alone in this universe?
Man, those are the two big questions that my boss, Bill Nye, likes to ask. You know, where do we come from and are we alone? This telescope, if everything goes well, is going to go a long ways toward answering both those questions. It's going to look at stuff in our own neighborhood, as close as Jupiter, maybe help us understand that thing called the Great Red Spot, that storm that is so mysterious. And it's going to help us look back maybe to just 100 million years after the beginning of the universe and reveal the very first galaxies, the first lights to light up in our universe, and tell us a lot about how the universe came to be and how we came to be where we are. And along the way, it will be looking at exoplanets, planets going around stars that are light years away. If we're lucky, it's going to tell us what's in the atmospheres of those planets. And if we find things like oxygen, methane, other things that are often called biosignatures, doesn't mean that we found life elsewhere, but it's a strong piece of evidence.